worrying tonight about their family in China as the number of coronavirus cases rises. Their daughter-in-law and grandchildren are on lockdown in Wuhan, the epicenter of the outbreak.
CBS4's Kelly Rinke spoke to them. And Kelly, how are they doing?
They're doing very well. Diana Kirkenbauer is from Wuhan, China. Her husband grew up in Anderson. She traveled to that city to celebrate the Chinese New Year with her parents. Now she and her two little kids are cooped up in an apartment so they don't get sick too.
This.
Harry Kirkenbauer reads the news every day from his home in Anderson, Indiana.
Right now, you don't have any choice. You're following Trump.
Another headline he follows originates from 7,000 miles away, the deadly coronavirus in Wuhan, China. That's Harry's granddaughter, Tia, and grandson, Eric, keeping themselves occupied as they sit and wait in an apartment in Wuhan.
Okay, here is Tia. Tia, say hi.
The kids traveled to the city with their mom, Diana. She grew up there.
Try to not pass the virus to other people, but now we are healthy, so we feel pretty lucky now.
They're staying with Diana's parents. She only ventures out to these empty streets to get food and water.
And this is the last bag.
Always wearing masks to stay healthy. While she stays in the lockdown zone of the deadly coronavirus, she worries someone in the family will get sick.
Hospitals are a lot. The doctors and nurses are very, very crazy busy every day. They have no any rest.
Her husband, Chris, Harry's son, is still in Nanjing, China, where they work and live. He stayed behind as he recovers from shoulder surgery.
That's probably the biggest problem we have, is we have no idea how long this is going to last.
A State Department chartered flight evacuated hundreds of Americans out of Wuhan to California. Chris says his kids were offered a seat on that plane. His wife could not go since she's not an American citizen, so they decided to not take that offer.
Not really life-threatening for them, but it could be life-threatening for my father-in-law because he's older and he has some health issues.
He had lung cancer, so it's always a worry about that because he might be more vulnerable.
Back home in Indiana, Chris's parents hope their family stays healthy and the number of cases start to go down.
Hopefully, sometime down the future, they'll come back home.
Right now, the family doesn't have another plan to get out of Wuhan during this lockdown. Diana says the quarantine is also delaying school for her two kids, so they've had to start online classes, guys.
Wow. Right, we'll take it out safely.
Yeah, we'll keep an eye on that story as it continues. All right, let's talk about our weather right now, John. We are waiting for the sunshine, and boy, we just haven't had any for days and days.
We are stuck under this inversion, basically where warmer air is on top of colder air, and it's just not allowing the clouds to break up and move away. We will finally start to see some changes coming our way as we head towards the weekend, but with that, we'll also bring us an Alberta Clipper, which we'll talk more about in just a moment. Live look right now from Fishers at Alderman Automotive, and look at the flags. They are not moving, so there's not a lot of wind. There hasn't really been a lot of wind the last couple of days. We still have a chance for a few snow flurries out there tonight. I don't think it's going to be a big deal as we go through the overnight hours, but there will be a chance for a little of that as we go through the overnight. Otherwise, you can see on FutureView in our high-resolution computer model, keeping our clouds just right over the top of us. So basically, we've got a 3,000-foot blanket over the top of us, which will not allow temperatures to drop too much tonight. Right now, we've got 32 degrees here at the station, 34 in Columbus. It's 35 degrees right now in Bloomington. By morning, we'll only drop down to 30. So we're going to drop maybe 2-3 degrees at the most with a very light breeze or light wind as we go through the overnight. Through the day tomorrow, with cloudy skies similar to today. Still at 30 degrees at 9 o'clock, up to 33 by 11, and then we top out right around 34 degrees. So we'll spend much of the afternoon and, frankly, even into tomorrow evening. 34 is what I'm forecasting for Indy, up to 35 in Muncie, and 37 degrees in Bloomington. Now, we're talking about the weather system that's going to bring us some sunshine. Before the sunshine gets here, we've got this little upper-level energy right here over the Pacific Ocean. That's going to come up, move up into Canada, and come down as an Alberta Clipper. That's going to bring us a chance for a little rain, some snow, perhaps, as we go through the day on Saturday. Now, on Friday, we will have a chance for a few snow flurries, maybe a few light snow showers around here Friday morning. That'll quickly move off to the east. Then we're going to watch the system develop and quickly slide through here. Again, maybe some rain in the morning, may end with a little snow towards afternoon and into the evening. The thing you'll notice on Saturday is temperatures in the low to mid-40s. So we're not going to be necessarily cold for snow, but I think as temperatures drop Saturday night into Sunday morning, we may see a little developing. And then on Sunday, we see some sunshine returning our way, and with that, some much warmer temperatures. The last several days have been in the 30s, but notice as we go through the weekend and into early next week, the heat or the warmth begins to move back into the state. We're talking high temperatures in the mid-50s on Sunday, approaching 60 on Monday. 7-day forecast, 38 Friday, 43 Saturday, up to 55 Sunday afternoon. It's going to turn breezy Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. And then temperatures starting to fall again for Tuesday and Wednesday.
All right, John, thank you. CBS4's Dave Griffiths joins us now with sports. This is the night Pacer fans have been waiting for long time. Mm-hmm. Why is that, Bob? There's some guy named Vic, I think, who's going to be playing.
Victor, oh, okay. Victor. It's news to me. No, it's not news to me. Yes, this has been a big deal. 1 year and 6 days of grinding to get back. And finally, that journey ends for Victor Oladipo as the Pacers All-Star returns to the court tonight. Our Chris Widlick is at Bankers Life Fieldhouse downtown. He joins us live. Hi, Chris.
Hello, Dave. It is Victor Oladipo night. Number 4 is finally back in game mode, and he will play for the first time. And as you mentioned, a lot of days, a little over a year, as the Pacers take on the Bulls. We got our first pictures of him on the court just a few minutes ago. Let's take a look. Victor Oladipo had all smiles, had a brace on that injured right leg, and he was also wearing special Kobe Bryant purple shoes. Now, we have learned he will not start tonight. He's on a 24-minute restriction. And we know it's going to take time. In his mind, it's all part of a process, but even his coach knows tonight is going to be special.
Absolutely, it's a buzz. You know, everybody's excited for Victor to, you know, be back out on the floor. And, you know, for us, you know, we're excited as well. You know, we have to come out and take the same approach we've been taking with this game, though, you know, try to take care of business, come out with that energy. We can't come out relaxed or trying to get Victor off. He will work his way, you know, back into shape and, you know, playing the game. So, yeah, we know that it's a buzz. Everybody's excited, including us.
As you think is who you are, and I'm VO. Like, that's not going to change. Now, obviously, you know, I got to go out there and play and get used to the game and get my legs under me and everything like that, but I'm still VO. Like, that's not going to change. My mentality is completely different. Like, there's no doubt in my mind that I'm going to be better than I was.
Well, Vic says he does expect some criticism. He's not going to be all the way back, but he quoted Kobe Bryant saying, "I don't fathom failure. It isn't real." And he does expect a special tribute to Kobe Bryant tonight on his big night. For now, we're live at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Chris Widlick, CBS 4 Sports.
Thank you, Chris. Plenty to get to on the college hardwood tonight as well. We'll start with Indiana. The Hoosiers are on the road to take on Penn State. Nittany Lions just rose into the rankings at 24th this week after wins last week over both Ohio State and Michigan. It's a banner year for the program. It's first top 25 ranking in 24 years. Tip-off is set for 8:30 p.m. Notre Dame will get started a bit earlier, 7 o'clock tip on tap, hosting Wake Forest at the Joyce Center. Two teams bottom out the ACC standings with only 2 league wins apiece, and those two are the Irish and the Demon Deacons, so it is a battle to get out of the conference cellar. We'll check in on both of those tonight at 11. Of course, a little bit from the Fieldhouse, I'd imagine, we'll sneak in there as well.
All right.
One or two things.
Dave,
yes.
Thanks. Next at 6 o'clock, helping students and families in one school district just by using an app.